Jüss. Klar. Schauen wir uns erstmal an.
It's not only bad, it will be super mega bad. Okay, so. Ja, let's continue, right? Ja, okay.
The cheap tones, ja, was war da?
Ah ja, the cheap tones, the cheap tones. Can we just call it through the point? Yeah. You hear Paul gives a beast, give a beast, yeah,
it's,
sure. Yeah, get a verse here, Paul. It's not verse, but yeah, you get the point. Each time you play, it's not playable. Each time you play a beast this turn, add a random beast to your hand. Nah, yeah, no.
Yeah.
It's thought with a marsh queen, right? That you can play this and then you get three random beasts, but it's weird.
No, you just want to kill your opponent. Also, this card seems fun. Let's not play it.
No, let's not play it. Trigger a friendly minion. Yeah, that's not good, right? There are already cards which do the same. We talked about this. I don't think it's good. Crackling Razor Maw. You would only play this if you're really running completely out of 1-drops and you want badly additional 1-drops. But even then, not. Okay, 2 mana, 3 to adapt a friendly beast. What about that one? No, obviously. Let's not talk about Hunter. We do this. So let's not talk about the Hunter cards. We want to play this. Yeah. And as such, the other cards become irrelevant. Awesome. Mage.
Pyros, not too bad, but a control card. What is it?
Against the Hunter? Yeah, it's always about the Hunter. If you say Hunter or Pirate Warrior, then this is probably not good enough. Yeah. Even if it comes back again and again and again.
The Mage
cards. Maybe you Time Warp. Six spells that didn't start in your deck. Meteor. 15 damage to a minion and 3 damage to adjacent one. So it basically reads it's an assassinate with collateral damage. For the collateral damage, it's an assassinate, guys, believe me. Dealing 15 damage should usually be sufficient to kill a minion. So, assassinate which deals 3 damage to adjacent ones. Assassinate sucks. 4 mana. Assassinate would be okay, I think. I mean, there's 3 mana hex, but I guess 4 mana assassinate would be fine. So for 2 additional mana, you deal 3 damage to adjacent ones. Kind of not worth it, because if you think about it, they will always put now the biggest minion on the left or on the uppermost right. And then you always have only one collateral. So I don't believe this card to be good. Primordial Glyph. Discover a spell, reduces cost by 2. No. Or is there so much? Are there many cards with space synergy? Because that would be the only reason, right? Otherwise, it's just not good.
No,
it's not good, you say. Okay, good. Steam Searcher. If you play an elemental last turn at the Flame Gazier, let's check out what the Flame Gazier is.
Also rechts steht, da rechts ist doch die Karte. Die war auch gerade auf der selben Seite. Da, Gazier, siehst du nicht?
Ah. At the Flame Gazier to your hand, Flame Gazier. Deal to damage. So it's a card.
It's not bad, no, it's like...
Which is kind of... Yeah, it's... Naja. It's probably worth 1.
But can you
1.5. It's okay, but it's not insane or something. Of course you play it in an elemental deck, and of course you play it twice. I mean, that goes without saying, right? How OP? I guess, I mean, you also need to play elementals, so that boils down to how expensive it will be to run elementals. Maybe it's possible. Molten Reflection, choose a friendly minion, summon a copy of it. No. I mean, there's Faceless Manipulator, right? So, and with him, you can also summon. It's just not good. Mana Bind. When your opponent casts a spell, add a copy to your hand that costs 0. Oh, it's a secret.
Mm-hmm.
So, you bind a spell. Interesting, but naja. It's a nice secret. It might be better than the other secrets. Yeah, now I know. This is like average probably here. It's alright. That's alright here, the Flame Gazier. But the Arcane Knowledge is pretty good. 2 mana, 2, 3, draw a secret.
Nerf
awesome.
Scientist. Nerfed.
I mean, as a matter of fact, he is a nerf scientist, but yeah. You can play him in curve. So
Why do I keep printing these cards and a rent? But at least it's a mage spell, another. But still.
It's random. It's an elemental. It's a bad card, probably, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So not very appealing.
Yes. Wo sind wir?
Oh, they're also stone to spores, yeah. But patches can just be better than stone to spore, that's the thing. I use woman on tracking, but by turn 4 you have mana left anyway, so it is actually correct. I think by the time you want to chain raptors, you already should use hero power every turn.
Lefkoe is gonna make a busted aggro deck.
So we have 4-1 mana death rate, that's insane. So priest quest can be done, it seems. So what is it then? Priest, pirates, and hunter are cool. Okay, probably not pirate. Why should you play pirate if you can play hunter? Why? Thais, Rada, and Mibi have completely different opinions on new cards. What are the biggest differences?
Stimmt einfach nicht.
Das stimmt hier einfach nicht, das hier raus.
Ja.
Yeah. Naja, stimmt aber nicht, ja. You already thought, said that we clean out your deck. But we said it before, so maybe you missed the start of the...
Froland ist auch da.
What? Where is Froland?
Ist oben.
Froland ist in der Haus.
Ja, da.
Oh.
Der Schraubenzieher.
Ja, yeah, der Schraubenzieher, cool. Good stuff. Awesome. Ein Schraubenzieher. It's a, here's like a bench.
Yeah, the bench.
Cool.
He's not even mod in your channel.
This used to be a Gwen stream. Froland wants us back to Gwen.
No, we just come to Hearthstone to figure out some mechanics and help you out, guys.
Yeah,
we
yeah,
will
yeah.
not force you into do your own deck building.
Yeah, do your own deck building. Don't play the hunter, guys. Don't play the hunter.
That's the last thing we will make you do. We will build the decks for you.
But don't play the... Okay.
That's our dedication, building decks for you guys. Can't let it happen that you go into Klein and build your own decks. No, no, no.
For, definitely isn't stronger than Flamebreath Faceless. Oh, yeah. Sure.
Klar. Läuft.
Läuft. So what? Meteor King of Flamestrike? No, I don't think so, actually.
Nein, das einfach nicht.
Yeah. Shaman doesn't shoot at your face every turn, that's the difference, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, the mage quest...
What about the quests? Is this good or what?
Ach, the time... You get an extra turn. We can evaluate...
That's where that didn't start in your deck. Which means yeah. this might be one and what else?
Yeah.
This might be one or what?
Yeah,
the and then what?
You have to drop the 2 mana mage spell.
And at one time do you want to play the... At which round do you believe this will happen, the 6 spells that didn't start in your deck?
You have to cast them.
Yeah, I don't see it, to be honest.
If you have a simulator...
Where is it? Oh, Meta Define, look. Everybody loves it.
Meta... Oh, how is it on a Hunter card? I want to see it. Meta Defining.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Patches was also not meta defining, by the
no,
way.
I know why you
for nobody.
Na, dann machen wir hier die Hunter Quest.
Achso, ja, wo ist die?
The Mars Queen, hier da.
Ja, ich bin ja dabei. Achso, hier habe ich noch.
Oh ja, gehen wir runter. Meta defining. Oh, oh man.
Yeah? No, no, no. How can be this 55.8? That cannot be. The other one is also exactly 54. Oh, no, no. Okay, no. It's not exactly the same. Okay, I was just wondering. Okay. Simply, probably. No. Unless Time Warp wins you the game immediately. Does it?
No.
What does Time Warp do? Where is it?
Gives you an extra turn. It yes. gives you an extra turn.
For 5?
Yeah.
What? And what?
And yeah, and what?
And warp.
And warp.
And warp.
Ja, total. Das ist doch der Überdreh.
For what? Meta defining. Oh yes. Because you pay 6 mana. And one card to do what?
Yeah,
and you have to cast the spells.
Yeah, I know why it's called Time Warp. Because if you're a top legend, you have to play another game. because you dropped again.
Yeah. It's like it warps in time 3 days ago, because yeah, you have to play another 3 days to get it back, the MMR. Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Oh,
okay, man. So this can be so bad. Okay, but whatever. Putting aside, if you really get overrun by the Hunter quest, by the way. Yeah.
White Pyro destroys the Hunter deck.
Pyro?
The White Pyromancer destroys the Hunter deck.
What is that, by the way? Yes. Finish at Legend 20. No, 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 we didn't finish anything. I don't know what that is.
Keine Ahnung.
I don't know. Maybe, just ignore this. Okay, we didn't play Hearthstone last month. Well, actually, we did. You play. You won the tournament.
Ah, yeah, I won Trinity Series.
You won Trinity Series, yeah, okay. But besides that, okay.
Grand Stream.
Okay. Yes, of course we want to play. Mainly the Hunter cards.
Yeah, yeah, Bonnie Hopper. Yeah. We did the math. Where's the simulator?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, we did that. Yeah. Was? Das ist echter Bunny Hopper,
ja? Ja,
klar. Modern, oder?
Ist es der echte?
Ja, ich nehme an, ja. Gemoddet, ja?
Was, sind Frodo noch nicht gemoddet?
Der ist schon gemoddet, oder?
Nee, nee.
Ja, aber der ist ja, der hat ja alle Rights,
ja,
oder?
Ja, ja, ich denke schon.
He has all the Rights, okay. New anti-aggro cards, we will check that out.
Yeah, yeah, we will check the anti-aggro cards. Don't forget. And the Wild Pyromancer, I don't think.
Oh, the mass on interrupting the chain once you have it. Oh, no, 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 I got what you're saying. So, it's basically pretty simple, right? So, if you fulfill the quest by 4, you get by 5, you play the queen. So, yeah, about the chain. What about the chain? So, but it's just roughly. So if quest fulfilled by turn 4, yeah, then draw one card, play queen, and then turn 6, average one. In the end, you have 15 out of 30 cards are raptors. So you have one raptor, you draw another card. So in average, you will probably deploy, yeah, 2 raptors plus 2 other cards plus 0 power, which fills out your turn, which is pretty sick. If you are lucky, unlucky, maybe you only have one raptor, then you might play one raptor, one other card, hero power. Maybe you also play the random beast, because you get random beast. So you can also play random beast and one drop. Maybe you play random beast and one drop and hero power. You will fill out always. You always fill out. Yeah, always fill out. And turn C, V7, you also always fill out. You always fill out because, well, either you played one warden, or you played one high main, or you got one random beast, or you high rolled on the raptors. So what is that?
Turn 7. You drew a war. Yes.
So you might run out of cards by turn 8, maybe, but it depends on your
if he lives.
If he lives, and also it depends again hugely on your deck build. If you play more Highmans, if you play more Wardens, you don't break at turn 8.
But then, no worries, the deck build, this is what we are here for.
We try to figure out the best versions, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, of course. We will give our best, sure. Of course. Sometimes in early AoE, they destroy the quest. I mean, first of all, they don't destroy the quest. They only destroy the minions. That's a difference. And we will see about it.
They also said the same about pirates.
Yeah, yeah, and about the... Oh, yeah, the patch is only 1-1. I always forget about that.
Guys, just remember about these review streams when we reviewed patches.
Yeah,
I was reading similar.
Yeah, exactly, yeah, yeah, yeah. So.
Was haben Sie da gesagt?
Yeah, that it won't be. That it will never be patches.
It will never be.
Patches will always be so bad and blah, blah, blah. And in the end, of course, we only saw patches for a quarter year.
Awesome. I think patches had a 39% of being meta defining. We gave it a solid 90. Yeah,
it was pretty good. And even the Dragon Priest saw the appearance in the end, if you remember, but whatever.
After.
Because the very first was we just overlooked Acro Shaman a little bit. True. We said Acro Pirate, Patches Warrior and Dragon Priest. Which basically happened after the Buccaneer got nerfed. So yeah, arguably we overlooked with the Buccaneer into the Fae Shaman. Sure. Of course, yeah. But I mean overlooked, it's not really overlooked. It's like, yeah, sure. Then it's like Patches Shaman instead of Patches Warrior. Or both. Awesome. So Time Warp already exists in Shadowverse, and there it's a busted card. Yeah, it's probably also a busted card in Magic the Gathering. Does it make it a busted card in Hearthstone? No. Okay. Now good. So, let's continue. What is this for argument even? This could also read, cast 20 spells that didn't start in your deck. Then it would also not be good, right? I mean, there are some thresholds which make the card bad.
Cast six spells, so you have to get six spells which weren't in your deck, and then you also have to cast them.
Yeah, no, but what is this an argument? It's good in another game to take another turn, so it has to be good in Hearthstone. I mean, sure, awesome. Yeah, we will just see about it.
Guys, okay. Just think about it. You have to get six cards which you didn't even have in your deck.
Let's just let them all play.
Okay.
It's fine. We probably won't face those decks on high legend rank. It's fine. Yeah, whatever. Okay. Yeah, and that's probably the reason why I said Blizzard was not learning from mistakes. I even pointed out that they should not print the Hunter quest. Yeah, after they asked me about the opinion about the upcoming, it was basically the only card which I said don't do that. Yeah, and what did they do? Yeah. They just released it anyway, it's okay, whatever. Yeah, I have no words for that. Okay. Because they first asked after my opinion, giving me the set, then I said, yeah, don't do this card.
They did the card.
They did the card, yeah. I have no words for that, it's so stupid, I don't know. That's really not cool. Yeah, because I also spent some days to evaluate the entire thing.
You evaluated wrong.
No, but then they should just not ask. Then I also don't need to waste my days to tell them what.
You evaluated wrong. Where you realized it? Okay. Nine. Yeah, we will see. We will see.
We will just see. But this card will never be good. It will only be what I said. Is there's a 50-50 that it's broken. Yeah, and in 50% of the cases it's just bad. Not bad, but in 50% of the cases it might not be good enough. But then there's no gain from it. But in the other 50% of the cases it's just broken. And if it's broken, it completely diseases the entire meta, yeah, which is actually not very cool. Yeah, but they did it anyway, so whatever. Yeah, that was really cool. Yeah. So Priest is right, we'd be done by turn 6-7 and has a lot of strong early death rate minions. Sure, but that's what I'm talking about. So if you have, let's say, Hunter and let's say Priest, even let's just assume Priest would counter Hunter. Yeah, then you would have Hunter and Priest. Awesome. Is it good? No? Cool. Yeah. If that would be like that. Yeah.
So you say it's not good to have a super polarized meta between two classes, the counter and the class you have to counter?
They are saying something about the arc, and yeah, maybe.
Was?
No, we will just see. I mean, there will be a lot of surprises, I'm sure. Okay, I think it will be too slow, but whatever. Putting the 5-drop in your deck twice is not worth it. This gives you somewhat lower chance to fulfill the quest. But once you play the cut after completing the quest, pretty sure it makes it GG. Yeah, exactly. So it just makes it slower. If you put in the 5-drop into the deck, it makes your entire general game plan slower, but more reliable. So the question is, how much do you want to convert reliability tempo? How much do you want to convert tempo into reliability? That's basically what it is. Yeah. Okay. A time warp, yeah, Droska. We will just see, guys, really. It's like, I think it's just... Yeah, we will just see about it. Yeah, I mean, the mage, we will just see about it, seriously. I mean, it's so complicated to evaluate the mage. My first impression would be it's rubbish, okay? And then there might be eventually a way to make it run. So I don't want to completely exclude it, yeah? That it might be good, but...
Time Warp Freeze Mage.
Yeah, let others find out how to make this card good. Because on paper it's not. Okay. Time Warp Freeze Mage, exactly. Okay, ba-ba-bum. So... Yeah, okay, let's continue.
Yeah.
Paladin! 6 mana, 3/7 Taunt, Battlecry said all other minions attack and heads to 3. We have a similar card, which is 7 mana, 3/7, and sets all the attacks to 1. Attack to 1 is better than setting everything to 3. Correct?
Yeah.
It also buffs your minions, so whatever. It's a little bit cheaper, it's Taunt. It's okay. I think it's okay. Yeah.
What the is last this? Kaleidosaur.
What does it mean?
Yeah.
It's okay, it's not good. It's like okay. It's playable, yeah.
Cost 6 spells on your minions. You get a dinosaur. Galvadon.
Oh, where is it? Where's the dinosaur? Is 6 spells on your minions, I mean that's pretty okay. And what where's Galvadon?
Galvadon is
probably not good, right?
It's actually pretty good. If you play it you win base set.
Oh, okay, where is it? Where is it?
He reads adapt 5 times.
You say you win? Do you?
If you adapt.
We said 1.5 mana, 5 adapt, 7.5 mana. It's like a 12.5 mana card. Everything pressed into 1. Can you assassinate then?
Yourself, right?
Your stealth, yeah.
But what does adapt do? What are the adapt options? Can you look over them?
Wind Fury, Stealth.
Yeah, you just win, probably.
Ach, you say with the win, it's not. If it doesn't have. I don't think you win automatically.
If you have Wind Fury, Stealth, and plus.
Let's just assume he has like 12 or 13, okay? So then it's like a plus 6. And you say plus 6 is alright for 1 mana. So that's like 5. And you have to play 6 spells on your minion. How easy is that to be accomplished?
What do you have? Look at the Paladin things.
Spells. Did it read spells?
Spells. Yeah. Here, some. What do we have?
2. 2. 4.
4.
6.
6.
8. No, is it? Yeah. 8. No. Okay, sure.
You have to play minions and cut. It's so hard. This is absurd.
Absurd.
This is really. I mean,
Dinosites. It's nonsense. It's bad. Dinosites. Or you can play this spell on your minions.
Oh yeah.
It's not good, right? This card cannot be good.
You can dinosize.
Yeah. Okay. Primeval Champion. Return any spell you cast on this minion to your hand.
So this is probably a synergy card with the quest.
Yeah, unfortunately.
He's only 1/2.
He's only 1/2 for 2 mana.
Ah, what a pity.
What a pity. Bang. Okay. Spike Ridged Steed. Give a minion +2/+6.
Taunt. And a Stegodon is a 2/6 taunt.
Is there some reason, is there some way to make weapons cheaper? Because otherwise, this is probably just bad, right? Yeah, okay, it probably is just bad. Okay. What is this? What is this? But it does summon Stegodon. Ah, yeah, okay, yeah, sure. Oh, that's one of these spells. I don't know. So what is this? Adapt your Silverhand Recruits. Nope. Hydro 3.5. Nah, nicht so gut. No, it's not that good. Hydrologist? Yeah, that's okay.
Ja, ist wieder so ein Scientist-Viech.
Ja. Lost in the Jungle? Well, whatever. No. Adaptation? No.
Was ist mit den Rekruten? Ist nicht so schlecht in Lost in China, oder?
Was? Wäre okay, but they're also not that great, right?
Ja, yeah, whatever.
Ja, yeah, whatever.
Ja, yeah, Priest.
Was? I don't know. Let me check out.
Ach, so viel schon wieder, ja? Oh mein Gott.
Was so viel?
Was war's?
So viel Chat, gell, oder was? Nee, was?
Yeah,
oh, wow, wow.
Oh mein Gott, ey.
Ja, yeah, okay, okay. Hm.
Hm.
People thought Koldora was OP. No. Whom?
Guys, it's not about time warp or any quest. Of course the quest rewards are going to be good unless it's rogue.
No, but it's also... What? Yeah.
The quest rewards are going to be good. Yeah, we can assume that. It's just a question how hard is the quest to fulfill.
And then what is even this argument here? And right about the... not saying blah, but many pros were so dead wrong about the new cards. What dead wrong? Patches, yeah. I mean... We said that's OP, Dirty Red, I mean whatever. Koldora Drake, what? Other says it's OP. I don't think we were one of those who said that. And Mysterious Challenger was obvious from the beginning that he's broken. I mean, I also always said so. So what's the point? I mean, sure. Specifically if you take these examples, by the way. Okay. Same, by the way, for Dr. Boom. Yeah, just saying. Okay. Yeah, there is synergy. I think Paladin won't be played. Okay, but yeah, no, there are new Paladin buff spells. It's try them out,
guys. At this review, I think we just want to be super realistic. We want to be we don't want to talk about this might happen combos. We want to be super realistic.
Yeah.
We want to give you a clear insight how the cards might work in a meta like Nuke. Not like a might be, could be, there is a combo, this is a combo. We want to have meta, playable meta decks, and we also, also review the cards like that. So yeah, it's not one side, we just want to make it realistic and not tell you something about the clouds in the air. You know, it's like...
Oh, but the clouds in the air are pretty nice.
Yeah, they aren't there today. Ja, stimmt doch. Also, es ist immer, wenn ich mir Reviews angucke, ist immer dasselbe, weißt du?
Yeah, of course I can, Armin. You just write a message or just write a mod a message. And they, if you apologize, they will definitely unban you. So, okay. Eh? What is this? Yeah, sure. Did you watch my other reviews? They were not more negative. They were not more positive than this one. But yeah, sure. Okay. And it was also always the same, guys. So I'm already used to it. My reviews are always rubbish. Yeah, I already got used to it because it's it was like this: the last review, the review before, and the review before the before the review before the review before the review. Yeah. But you know what, guys? You don't even need to look at it if you don't want to. You can also just leave the channel and watch some other reviews. I mean, it's what JJ basically said. It's about being realistic here. And as you know, I don't... It's not even about the hype. Of course, I would like to tell you something different. I also love the game. Just not with the cards. They are there. Which are there. So, of course I want to hype it up. But what should I tell you? Yeah? Oh, Song! Oh, Mojo! Reflect! Oh! Nein, of course not. Yeah, I'm realistic and also honest. Yeah, I just state my opinion. Then you can try whatever you want to. Yeah, have fun. Okay, so
same thing every expansion. Salty people about life coach's opinion.
Yeah, exactly.
Like with the patches.
Yeah,
don't be so negative.
Yeah, it's always TGT or whatever. I don't know. Yeah,
yeah.
I really gave it up on that one. And yes, of course, we might be wrong about the one or the other thing. Obviously, sure. I mean, we are also not, let's say, as arrogant to not counteract our opinion or shape our opinion. So if the new meta suddenly is completely different from what you predicted, sure, not a problem. Then we say, yeah, cool, awesome. It's not aggro anymore. Now it's very cool. Games go until turn 10. Let's play some Hearthstone. Yeah, awesome. Until turn 10, maybe even until turn 12, whatever, who knows. Maybe you're dead wrong. Yeah, sure.
It actually fits, right? If you have Unguru, it's like a forest, and the king of the forest is
The jungle queen.
The hunter.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. The hunter. And he shoots you in the face.
Yeah, he hunts alone.
He hunts alone. Yeah. He hunts alone. Okay. Okay, fair enough, fair enough. Okay. Wow.
Yeah.
Pretty good.
Yeah, it makes perfect it's pretty, sense it's now.
Pretty good.
I got
it's
it.
It's pretty good.
They were telling us all along. Yeah.
So. Yeah, maybe we get to the rogues later. Well, a secret hunter. Did he ever make secret? Oh, whatever.
Secret? Yeah, yeah. Du meinst, dass ein secret hunter so stark mm-hmm. ist?
No, I don't. No, what this?
Secret hunter. He was even a deck at some point. What happened? Oh yeah, secret hunter was a deck before pirates. Oh, I remember.
That's awesome. That's awesome.
What?
No, no, it just...
Okay, ja gut, weiter geht's.
Weiter geht's.
Ah, Paladin, ja, nicht so toll. Oh, Priest.
I
actually like... Oh nein, oh nein. Oh, da sind ein paar dreckige.
No, I don't know. Let's continue. Let's do here. Whenever you cast a spell at a random priest card to your hand. So that's a 5 mana 3 fighter elemental. Whenever you cast a spell at a random priest card, how's it?
5 mana 3 5.
Not good. No. I mean, 5 mana 3 5 is not good, but maybe you can combine it later.
Whenever you cast a spell at a random priest.
I mean, as a 5 mana 3 5, it cannot be good. So you need to also cast a spell in the. I don't like it. I don't like it.
No.
But since you're. I mean, yeah, I don't like it. So what is this? Awaken the Makers. So it's like 1 mana, 7 Death Rattle minions. And then the question is how difficult it will be to summon 7 Death Rattle minions.
Or how many good Death Rattle minions
are. There are, exactly. If you get it, you get Amvara. Where is she?
No, look at tokens.
Should be here somewhere? Tokens, what do you mean tokens?
Where is it? She's nowhere. You have to click on discuss the card or something. Right?
Discuss the card or the token. And then before it was always here, the link.
Ah, der Closet of Faramaho. Aber Amara.
So she's a 5 mana 8/8 taunt, which sets your hero stats to 40. I mean, is it not like the very similar to the hunter thing? Where, I mean, the one gives you the March Queen, the other one gives you the Hope. March Queen trades against Hope, by the way. So, they trade one on one. Maybe if you don't want that, they also don't trade one on one, but...
The March Queen comes down way earlier, right?
She comes earlier, exactly. The one is a little bit less conditional. The one is like 7 1-drops, and the other one is 7 Death Rattle minions. And Death Rattle minions are usually more difficult to be achieved. But she also sets your hero stats to 40. Okay, the Hunter Quest gives you then the dudes into your deck. So how is she even?
Let's take a, we have to look at...
we have to take a look at the cards first.
Death
the Glorious Glimmerroot is fine. I think it's decent.
Weaker Dragonite Operator. It's a nice card.
It's a weaker Dragonite Operator. The Dragonite Operator was also super busted. That's a nice card, specifically because it goes into the 3 mana slot. So you go into the 3 mana slot, you have 3 mana, 3/3, and get the card from your opponent's deck. You cannot choose which one, but you get one card from your deck. And that's pretty good. This dude is cool. And it's also a little bit skill heavy. I really love this design. This is awesome. I love this card. Shadow Visions. Discover a copy of a spell in your deck. No. Free from Ember. No, right?
No.
Okay. Mirage Cola, choose a friendly minion, summon a 1/1 copy of it.
With Death Rattle theme.
No. What, Death Rattle? No, it's Battlecry.
Yeah, I mean, you can copy the Death Rattle.
Ah, you think it's good?
What is it compared?
Maybe it's okay, but I don't know.
Summon a 1/1.
Difficult, depending on the Death Rattles. Yeah, the Death Rattles. Copy a card from your opponent's deck and add it to your hand. How's that? That's fine, right? That's cool.
This shard.
That's awesome.
It's cool.
I call it awesome. It's cool. You can play it. It's a
Death Rattle. Play. Yeah, klar, aber es ist halt irgendwie so wieder so random Kack, aber ja.
Yeah, okay, true. Total and Shell Razor, yeah, that's decent, sure. Of course, yeah, it's better than Ascension. Quite better.
So Visa, good Visa, yeah.
That's really true, yeah, it's also good.
You run this 2 times, you run a shot 2 times.
I don't know about this, this is also nice, the Binding Keel. Can be nice, I don't know. But looks decent. Looks like a cool card.
And the Elemental is what?
Maybe, I don't know. It's 2 out of 3, I don't think so. Actually,
We need to take a look at death rattles. Oh, I mean, these are nice, like these turtle and such.
So, you want to,
give my here death rattle ein. Death rattle,
yeah. I got all the
steps. So, let's see what can we actually run. Boy, is echt nicht so. You can run the shifting shades, but we are formula. Oh, man, ey. So, what is it you? I guess if you want to counter the Hunter quest, I mean, you can obviously make it super anti-aggressive, right? Mistress of Mixtures, how do you do it even? You have 2 times Mistress. Yeah, it depends how, I think it's more about balance, right? Like a tentacle, yeah, maybe you want to run a tentacle against the Hunter. It really, like, I think the priest deck really defines, gets built on how strong the Hunter deck is, since the quest is obviously made. The quest is obviously made to beat aggro. So if you want to have a counter to the Hunter quest, you have to make a priest quest, which is, yeah, arguably consistently anti-aggressive. Yeah, so you will run, I mean, the 1-drops are quite okay to counter, like, the tentacles and such, if you want to counter the aggression, like, also the mixtures. Yeah. The only problem I see with this deck... Okay, you may, if you run this quest thing with the death rattles and such, you either make it, you either beat aggro, or you get killed by control. I think that's a problem. Because, yeah, after you bleed it out of aggro and you have 40 health, everything is nice. And then? How do you win? You need value, right? Exactly. So you probably need to run Ents of and the heavier death rattle things. So if the Hunter gets completed by turn 4 or 5, this quest... With, let's say, death rattle minions being way more conditional when one drops, obviously.
Yeah, way more.
You probably complete the quest by turn 8.
Yeah, I also think so. And what about the high main? I mean, the high main.
The high main also is like, I think, this is actually, like, you see the death rattles, right, guys? I mean, obviously, like, the shard. I mean, look at the shard. What is with the shard, right? It's a 1-mana, 1/1 copy. I mean, what is this concept? Copy a card from your opponent's deck and add it to your hand. If you want to play this deck, it's like, okay, I have this deck here, I have deck building. And you say, okay, I have to run these shards because they're very good. And then you have to high roll on your opponent's cards. That's not how you want to feel, right? That's not cool. Of course, the quest is cool and such, but I think the death rattle quality... First of all, I don't think there are enough cheap death rattles. There are some. And even if they're there, you don't want to run too many because,
Yeah, exactly. Because they are crap.
Because they are crap, yeah, obviously.
Yeah. Sylvanas also rotates out, right?
Sylvanas also rotates out.
Yeah, so that leaves... It's even crappier. Yeah, yeah.
Hey, guys.
I don't think so. I don't think so.
It really seems also like normally you say, "Ooh, death rattle! Now I can run in soft." Yeah, summon your mistress.
1 mana.
don't even. Hey, this is, it's really rough, guys. I mean, just compare it. Like, of course, the quest rewards. Yeah, you can print a card.
Yeah, probably not. Again, something to be tried out. But yeah,
it can be strong, but probably not.
Yeah, it will be different. Yeah. We will check this out.
It's just like, yeah, if the Hunter has... Okay, the Hunter has about 50% to be super broken. If it's broken, we are lost. I give the Priest and the Mage quest is about a 10% range. And then it's like, okay, sure.
Yeah.
Ist das so, oder?
Yeah, I don't know, also know exactly.
Yeah, Ensof, yeah, Ensof. What do you want to summon with Ensof? Probably no tentacles.
Yeah, I also don't see it. But okay, so yeah, the Glimmer, we already talked about this. Oh yeah, we already talked about those. Okay, cool. Rogue.
Those some cool. I mean, let's not talk about the Rogue quest, but yeah.
Yeah, so let's begin with the Sheriffs in the Corpse Lore. So the Sheriffs in the Corpse Lore is probably minus one, probably even a little bit more. So the question is, how does she pay itself for being 1.5 mana worse than she should be? And she can pay herself by appearing again, which she will if you play four cards in a turn, which might be possible. So, but it's not a card that you can build up your deck on because it's only a legendary. Number one. And number two, it's not even that overpowered. So I think it's a cool card. I really like the card design. That's awesome. But it's not super mega strong or something. It's just decent. And maybe we will see her. Cameron's below. Play for minions.
Yeah, sure.
And you get. But you have to get to win the game.
This quest is probably the hardest to achieve and the worst reward.
Okay, no, sure. Let's continue. The Wildfin Slayer. He is actually good. Yeah. I believe him to be good because, I mean, what does it mean, destroy a minion? We already said, like, 4 mana destroy a minion, that might be fine. So if you would have a minion, 4 mana destroy a minion. Let's say you would have 7 mana, 3, 4 destroy a minion. That would be break even, right? Kind of. Yeah, I think 3 mana 3 for Destro Mini would be very good.
Yeah.
Shonoda? A little bit too bad?
Bit too bad.
But for 6 mana it would be too good. For sure. 6 mana 3 for Destro Mini would be super good. Something in between, right? So you basically get this, let's say 6.5. So you get this 1.5 cheaper, but it's also combo. So this is like 1 mana cheaper than it should be. Arguably. What I'm saying is you will probably just play this guy 2 times if you play Rogue. Then again, it's also conditional. I would play it definitely 2 times. It's definitely good.
It depends on the meta, not if there are only 1 drop.
If there are only 1 drops, you don't play Rogue. If there are only 1 drops, you don't play Rogue. You know what Rogue does against Hunter.
Die.
Yes, it dies, yeah. Biteweed, it's like...
It's
bad.
It's plant win. Fun plant.
Fun plant, but it's only getting you +1/+1 instead of less. Yeah.
It's
even the questing adventure is better, right? Yeah.
Yeah, that was schlechter okay. As a question. Yeah. Cool.
Obsidian Shard. Now you can play...
And Burgle Rogue.
Burgle. No, but you can play with the other guys which steal from your opponent's deck.
The Slash Burgers, yes.
Yeah, and Patches, yeah. Sure.
Yeah, so Aggro Rogue. 3/3.
And then Obsidian Shard might become... One,
You mean Tempo Rogue?
I mean, it's 9 damage, so 9 damage, 3 mana in the card. So this should cost... I mean, if this would be a weapon, 3 mana, 3/3, would you play it? Yeah, that would be break even.
Yeah, it seems like... Yeah.
So you need to play 2 different... It's kind of very debatable.
It makes a hero power.
It makes a hero power. I don't see it, to be honest. As much as I don't see this. I mean, this gives you hero power poisonous. I mean...
With Blade Fury, or what?
Yeah, with Blade Works, I have Blade Fury. You don't want to play Blade Fury in your deck.
And I mean, if Blade Fury wouldn't be 4 mana, yeah. Hey.
You don't want to make your weapon poisonous, right? Because if you do, I mean, you might be. This is 5 mana, get... Probably not that good, right? No, probably not. Unless you want to face tank 8/8s.
They also included more weapon removal now. It's even
possible. Yeah, no. Draw a card and add a copy of it to your hand. No. Razor Petal Leisure. Add a Razor Petal to your hand that deals 1 damage. I mean, maybe it's a spell and you can prep it. So maybe. But yeah.
It's not just Razor Petal Lost, the Razor Petal.
No. I mean, the Mimic Pot maybe. Because it's a 3 mana spell and Rogue is usually happy to have 3 mana spells. But it reads that it's not that great. So whatever. Razor Petal Leisure, add a Razor Petal to your hand that deals 1 damage. No. Razor Petal is 1 mana, 1 damage. No, it's just not good. But it's a spell, so maybe... I don't know. Maybe. It's just too slow against
But usually you want a hero power on 2, but yeah, sure.
Yeah, exactly. So I'm also thinking if the Hunter is a thing, all of this work is futile. So what is this? Yeah, this is rubbish. And this is just better than this is, right? Okay, this is also a spell, but... I mean, guys, this is more... I don't know. I don't like it too much. But I can get it. You can play for 4 mana 3 spells, but still, I don't know.
Arcangiant Rogue.
Arcangiant Rogue, yeah.
And then make the Arcangiants 5/5s. With your quest.
Yeah. Yeah, that's really good. No, I don't know about this. Seems to be weak to me, but yeah. Hallucination. Discover a card from your opponent's class. Hallucination. Yeah, probably bad. Okay. But it's... I don't know. I really don't know about that.
Rogue is always to be seen, right? Because...
Because of what?
Rogue is just a class with surprises every time. You can't build always some kind of tempo-oriented rogue, right?
So, yeah. No. But not, if Hunter not is Hunter, there... not Hunter. Not against Hunter. Now, Shurazin is not that great. Sure not. Surely not, you know. 4 mana 5/4 doesn't seem play. I don't... What I'm talking about is about the card design. It's a nice card because that's good card design. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah. It's probably not strong enough. Yeah. It's close. It's not... That's when I say it's not even that great, I mean it's not that good. Yeah. So, probably you can not even play her, but the design is good. Because it does something a little bit more complex than just having raw stats. Okay.
Kill the rogue smog.
Just write a Twitch message if you... Okay, what is here? What? Why is the Hunter quest so highly rated when you can just play Midhunter with 2 5 mana 8/8s?
He means the Hydras, right?
Yeah, but they can also get dealt damage and maybe... I mean, 5 mana 8/8 is like 1.5, maybe 2 mana better than it should be. Definitely 1.5 mana better than it should be. And for that to take some damage... That was the other card. Okay, but whatever. Maybe that was the other card I was also thinking, having in mind that it might not be that healthy for the meta, but yeah.
The 5 mana 8/8.
Yeah, I basically said the Hunter quest should never happen, and the 5 mana 8/8, they should at least think about it. Because, again, there is a likelihood it's good, and if it's good, then it's just bad for the entire meta. And if it's bad, nobody plays it. Doesn't matter.
Ah, Fel Reaver, yeah, yeah. Wasn't there a
card? The Fel Reaver, exactly. So that was the other card where I said, yeah. Maybe you want to consider that as well, but yeah, sure. Whatever.
It doesn't even work with Blade Flurry.
Oh! Oh!
It's mit Trauerfest. Sogar dann würde ich mal sogar.
No, Petals are 1 mana, that's what I'm talking about. Yeah, I don't like it that much.
Yeah, you have to make assumptions about what's the best aggressive deck, because if you say it's a control meta, you don't need to compare it to the other control decks. It's just about, first of all, you have to ask yourself the question, are control decks are going to be playable? Because
yeah, exactly, if there is something which is extremely aggressive, why would you like to do all the theory crafting? So this is what I meant with Rogue. Yeah, of course Rogue has some kind of nice cards, right? So this Corpse Warrior, you're saying unplayable. Yes, of course, if there are any fast decks, it's completely unplayable. But if it's extremely control heavy, maybe it's not unplayable. Because maybe you can play her, she goes dormant, you can resurrect her, she goes dormant again, and you resurrect her again. But obviously that does only happen if the game prolongs 10 turns, because otherwise she's rubbish. And the same goes for the White Spine Slayer. He's insanely good against strong cards, but if they are not strong minions in the game, because the games are just going very quickly or are over very quickly, we can basically save the time to evaluate it. And if you say the hunter quest is broken 50-50, well, in half of the cases, we can just save ourselves the time. So we just play the hunter quest whenever this expansion hits. And then if hunter is broken or OP, well, you can save yourself crap loads of time. Believe me, you can if the hunter quest is really that broken. If it's not, fine, then you can still evaluate. Just dominated to evaluate the control decks too much or too long or put too much thought into them if you think or if there's a good likelihood that it just won't happen. Okay. Next class. Shaman. Kalimos the Primal Lord. If you played Elemental last turn, cast an Elemental Invocation. So for 8 we would like to see 10. So this is 7-7, so we would like to see 3. What are the invocations? Yeah. I just go down, yeah?
Yeah?
What are the invocations? Siehst du sie?
Da sind sie doch, ne?
Hier, los.
Ja, hoch. Da sind sie doch, hier die Invocations.
Hier.
Da ist halt
hier. Second row. Deal 3 damage to all enemy minions. That's actually... if we say we want at least 3 mana of value and invocation 3 damage to all enemy minions, it's definitely worth 6 mana. That's awesome. Pretty bored with one more elementals. That's kind of
Onyx, yeah.
Not that great. That's not that great, right? It's kind of whatever. This is definitely better than this. The 3 damage to all enemy minions is awesome, right?
Come on, is it random invocation?
Or? No, can you choose?
Can you choose? Oh, it's ziemlich cool, huh? Okay.
Yeah, able to choose.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Yeah. Restores 12 health, that's kind of 4 mana equivalent. 5. That's cool, if you need it, it's insane. And if you need this, it's also insane. Yeah. Yeah, you do this if you can kill him. So then it's pretty good.
It's a good card, right?
Of course it's a good card, yeah. But it's also legendary, right? But it's a good card, yeah, sure. What? You are not surprised. I mean, you also know that there was something like a Dragon Operative. He could have also been a legendary, but he just wasn't. Oh, what are you talking about? You're saying it has to be legendary because it's broken or what?
No, you said it's also legendary because it's not like because it's legendary, it's good. You said, look, okay.
It's just good, but it could also be. No, okay, also, no. It's a legendary. It's a legendary. It's not an epic, you cannot play it twice. You can play it once. Yeah.
He's good.
He's good, yeah, of course, yeah. And the question is how much does it cost you to play elementals, but he himself is good. A little bit slow though.
Fire elemental.
But is he 7-7 though? The poor dude, man.
That's the thing, it should be a
8-8. Should be 8-8.
Yeah.
It looks like Ragnaros. Why is Ragnaros the Light Lord 8-8, the Fire Lord 8-8? I mean, maybe it does have a reason. But the poor dude, man. Yeah. He's so powerful and he's only 7-7. Look at his elemental invocation. He's looking like the Fire Lord with a hat.
Yeah.
He's looking stronger. He's looking more badass than the Light Lord and the Fire Lord. You don't want to tell me that this is only a 7-7. Come on. Look at this. He's like this is like such a badass. Look at this. This is a human being and this is the elemental lord. The head is full of fire and look at the claws. Yeah. This is only a 7-7? Are you kidding me? Yeah, come on. I mean, I don't know, but that's not all right. But good. So, unite the Murlocs. 10 Murlocs. Right, 10 Murlocs. And what about the Megafin? So let's go. Megafin, yo, let's go. Fill your hand. What is this even for a Murloc? Look at the arm. Okay, now, 5-8-8, sure. What about the 10 Murlocs? 10 Murlocs is way more difficult than 7 1 drops. Can we agree?
Oh, it's summon, not play.
Okay, fair enough. And you get Megafin. And Megafin makes, again, Murlocs. 5-8-8. Fill your hand with random Murlocs.
Yeah.
Here's the thing. If this will ever happen, there will be the Hungry Crab in the Hunter deck. 2 times. So it probably won't happen, because if it happens, it doesn't happen. Okay, it's like Fight Club, the second rule and the third rule.
The crab can sogar ein Megafin fressen, oder?
Yeah, the crab eats the Megafin. Mega good. And you can even keep the crab because you know exactly what will happen if they play the quest. You see the quest. So if you have a crab, you just keep her. If there are any Murlocs around, you can even play only one crab. And then you can wait for the Mürgerküken. Yeah, whatever. And others will be fine. But yeah, let's take a look to the chat first and then let's continue. You also agree that it should be 8-8, right?
Yeah, it's also good as a 7-7. It's just...
No, I mean, you could also they make, like, more expensive.
Okay, sure.
Yeah, of course, that's not cool. Yeah, that the quest dictate the deck building. But that's, again, a course which is, I mean, yeah, it's not surprising. So,
it's a fish.
Yeah, I see the fish.
And Murlocs are?
Fishes. Actually, they are fish, yeah. Yeah, oh yeah, there are some Murloc stuff, yeah.
Oh yeah, call in the finishers.
Call the finishers. Okay. Okay, let's continue. Stone Sentinel. It's an epic, you can play it 2 times, 7 mana 4-4. If you play in the middle last turn, summon 2/3 elementals with taunt. So it's like 2/3 elementals is like 2.55. No, it's like 5. So you get 9 for 7. And it's an elemental, it's fine, it's absolutely fine. It's cool. Absolutely reasonable. Yeah, it's actually, yeah, it's decent, definitely.
Okay.
5+4, 7/9. You can play it definitely 1 time, maybe 2 times.
You get shaman cards. But these are actually these kind of shaman cards we wanted to see the last expansion, right?
Absolutely.
These are like the beautiful. These are the good shaman cards, not these blah.
Yes, definitely. Spirit Echo, yeah, whatever. Is it something? I don't think so, right?
Yeah, so this is Adventure's head.
Yeah, it's weird. Huh? Adventure's head? Give your minions to return this to your hand. This spirit echo, what? No, what? No. The minion. No, return this, right? So, what?
Ich glaube, the minion.
Yeah, the minion, eben. Yeah. Yeah, but it's not that good. Vulcan! Okay.
Volcano!
Yeah, I don't even comment on this card. Yeah, whatever. It's like, what do you want to hear? I mean,
oh, a tournament.
Are you kidding? I mean, I don't even want to comment on it. I don't even think it's good, but.
Primal Fin.
Primal Fin Totem.
That's good.
At the end of your turn, summon 1/1 Murloc.
Sure.
Sure. Fireplume Harbinger. There is a cost of elementals in your hand by 1.
No.
It's alright. If you have enough elementals, 5.
Ja, klar. Dann 2 hast du jetzt nicht,
oder? Title Search. Naja.
2.
Naja.
Deal 4 damage to a minion, restore 4 health to a minion. Okay.
Rather not. I mean.
Ja.
Ja, of course, the meta is Hunter. Okay. Yeah, okay. Yeah, then you would play the title searches, you would also play these probably, right?
These are good, yeah.
And they are obviously good against hunters.
They are? Yeah.
They are very good. Okay. Elemental, 2/4 taunt, restore 3 health. Yeah, this is just awesome, this says everything. So.
Taunt, but probably restore.
Yeah,
it's everything. It will all come down to one quest, guys.
Yeah, it will all come down to one
quest. Do you hear the march, Queen?
Boom, 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 boom. Sure. Now it can be good, whatever. I said I don't comment on it. I didn't say it's bad. I just said I don't comment on this random crap any longer. At some point, yeah, maybe it's good, whatever. I don't comment on it.